Hello everyone and welcome to Online Learning Center. So today we are going to talk about installing VMware Workstation, Ubuntu 19 and Java 8. Now if you're watching this video through my YouTube channel, I will suggest you to check my description link for more details about how can you get access to this document. Now I have created a very simple document which will help you to get started and install everything very quickly. Now let's check the prerequisite. So I will assume that you have at least i5 processor system with 4 GB of free RAM and at least 80 GB of free hard disk. Let's check if our system supports virtualization or not. So for that, just go to Google and search for Securable. So you will get a link like grc.com Securable. Click on it. Okay. And click on this download now. Say keep. Downloaded, just go to the folder and double click on it. Now if you see, it basically tells that my system is Intel Core i7. This is a 64-bit CPU and it supports virtualization. Okay, so this is very important. Now if it says no here, okay, you cannot install VMware on your Windows. That means your system does not support virtualization and you should directly install Linux Ubuntu as a dual boot system. Okay, so this is what we wanted to check it. Okay, now once it says yes, then I will suggest you that you restart your laptop, go to the BIOS setting and see if the virtualization is turned on or not. Okay, for example, a typical BIOS setup will look something like this, where you can see virtualization technology, and by default in some system it would be disabled. So please make sure that you check it out. And if it is disabled, then you enable it and reboot your system. Mostly while booting, you may have to press escape, F2 or F10, depending on your manufacturer. So just Google it out. You'll get to know what the shortcut key you need to press to see the screen, to get this BIOS screen. Okay. Now, once this is done, now let's talk about the software. What is required? So we will be downloading VMware Workstation latest. As of now, it's 15.x, but tomorrow it may change to 16.x, 17.x and so on. So the steps would basically remain same. Okay. So what we will do is we will just go to the website and directly we will download it from here. You can say VMware Workstation. Okay. So click on this VMware Workstation. So you can go to this try VMware Workstation 15.5 Pro, click on this download and you choose download it for Windows. Click on download now and it started getting downloaded. Now in the meanwhile, let us also go and download Ubuntu 19. Open another tab and say Ubuntu download. Now click on this download Ubuntu desktop. So this is Ubuntu 18. So what you can do is you go to this download. Okay. And then you can choose 19.10 as well. Okay. Choice is yours. You can either choose 19.10 or you can use 18.04. Let me go ahead with 19.10. So the download will start automatically and it will be completed in some time. By that time, let's move on and also download our Java 8. So again, go to another tab and just say Java download. All right. Now go to oracle.com website. By default, it will show you the latest version. Java 14 is the latest version, but we are not going to install Java 14 because we will have some problem while installing Hadoop on Java 14. It is not completely supported yet. So we'll go to Java 8. Let's go down. Here we go. We have a Java 8. So we will install Java 8 because this is completely compatible and we will not face any issues. So here you go and say JDK download. You'll come to this page. Now, which one to choose? Be very, very careful here. This is 64-bit Java and this is 32-bit Java. 32 bits are basically written as 8086x86. So we will go and download this 64-bit Java. So click on this. Okay. Now I say accept. Now, if you do not have your credential with Oracle, it will ask you to create a new account. Please do so and get this downloaded. Okay. So it's asking me to enter my credentials. So let me give my credentials here. All right. So by now we have VMware Workstation 15.5, Ubuntu 19.10, JDK 8, 241 Linux x64 version. Let's move on with the document. Okay. Now we can also install. Now we can also download IntelliJ. Let's do that as well. So I'll go to IntelliJ. and click on this, say download, and choose community version because it is a free version. Okay, so download which version? We will download it for Linux, right? So go to Linux and download this. All right, so it will also take some time to get this things downloaded. Similarly, let's go back and download Eclipse as well. So you can say download package. So from here, you can choose Eclipse IDE for Java developer and Linux 64-bit. And click on this link, or maybe this link, right? And it also started getting downloaded. So you can use either IntelliJ or Eclipse. We will see few examples using both of them, and gradually we will start using IntelliJ more and we will stop using Eclipse. Okay, so we have downloaded Eclipse and we have also downloaded IntelliJ. All right, so I've also updated the link for your reference. So the first thing is download and install VMware. VMware we have already downloaded. Now it's time to install it. So let's go back to VMware Workstation. Say yes. Click on next. I accept. Next. Simply say next. 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 Install. Now finally say finished. If you have the license, you can enter your license, but that's okay. We can say finished. So this completes our step one, download and install VMware Workstation. Now, second step, download Ubuntu 19 ISO file and save it to a location, say D drive software. We have saved it here. That's absolutely fine. Now let's go back and launch VMware. All right. Now you get this screen. So go to file and say new virtual machine because we want to create a new virtual machine. Typical, say next. So choose your Ubuntu image. So let's go to browse and say desktop and new installation and Ubuntu 19.10 desktop AMD. Okay, say next and give some details here. Full name, let me give name like Suraj. Username, let me give Suraj. Password, let me give Hadoop. And here also, let me give Hadoop. Say next. So what is the virtual machine name you want to keep? Okay, so I will say Ubuntu 19, 64-bit. Where do you want to install this VM? So let me choose something under D drive, virtual machine. I'll create a folder here, Ubuntu 19. Okay, and say next, what is the size you want to give? Okay, so I will recommend you to give at least 80 gigs because over the period of time when you start installing a lot of components, it will consume more and more space. So give 80 gigs of maximum disk size and you say split it into multiple files. Okay, it does not mean that it will by default take all 80 GB. It will increase slowly. Say next. And customize hardware. If you want to customize your hardware, you can go here and just upgrade your RAM to say 8 GB and upgrade your cores to 4 cores. Okay, you can do this later as well. It's okay if you don't choose anything as such. Close and say finished. All right, so once the setup is done, it will start your VMware. All right, so once that process is completed, it will reboot the system. It will take almost 40 minutes. And after 40 minutes, our Ubuntu would be up and running. So once your Ubuntu is rebooted, let's go to the next step. That is, check the software updater and click on install now. From here, search software updater, this one. And wait for some time. Now it will say updated software is available for this computer. Do you want to install it now? Say install it now. All right. So once this is done, it will ask us to restart our system. Say restart now. All right, so let's log in. Password is Hadoop. Okay, so we have completed till this step, step number 5, right? Now, check if the internet is accessible from Ubuntu or not. So the simple way would be, open your browser window and just say google.com. All right, so it is working. Yes, so it is working. Let's move to the next. Now, check copy paste from Windows to Linux is working or not. So what we will do is, let's just copy this text. Let's just copy this text, Control C. And let me just paste it over here anywhere, right? Which means the copy paste is also working from your Windows to Ubuntu. This is also done. Next, now follow the two command to update currently installed package to latest version. This is optional, but I will suggest you to do that, like sudo apt get -y update. So open your terminal, Control Alt N T will open a window and copy paste the first command, copy, enter, password is Hadoop. All right, so we have executed this command successfully. Now let's say sudo apt get y upgrade. Okay, so this is also done. And finally, let's say sudo apt get update. All right, now we are good. So we have done all these things. Now in this process, if you get any error like this, okay, that means either the installation is being used by some other tool. So I will suggest you to reboot your system once and retry this command again. It should work fine. Okay. Now the next thing what we will do is, let's install Vim, V-I-M, because V-I-M would be used to edit the file. It is very similar to VI editor and it is little better than VI editor. So we will use Vim. So let's install Vim. Control L, enter. Say yes, capital Y. All right, so this is also done, Control L. Let's move to the next. Now once this setup is done, let us install Java in our system. Okay, so we have already downloaded Java, right? So let's go back to this place. We've already downloaded this Java. What we will do is, let's say Control C, copy. Okay, go to Ubuntu, in my desktop, say paste. So this file is now pasted in the desktop of Ubuntu. Let's move on. So I'm saying, copy it to any location, say /user/local/java. So we have already downloaded it in our desktop. Now what we will do is, let us create a folder called /user/local/java. Okay, so user and local is by default present. Let's create a folder called Java. So sudo mkdir /user/local/java. Open terminal, say paste. Password is Hadoop. Okay, next, let's give all the permission to that folder, 777. Done. Next, let's copy the JDK file, whatever we have downloaded, the Java downloaded file, into user local Java. Okay, so make sure that you pick up the correct version. Let's check the version also. I'll say paste and then JDK. It's the same 8U241 Linux x64 tar.gz, right? Okay, so this needs to be copied under user local Java. Done. Next, now let's go to user local Java wherever we have copied that folder. Control L, LS. So you have jdk8u241linux.tar.gz. Okay, now let's extract that. Extracted. Say ls. Once we extract this, we get another folder called jdk1.8.0_241. Right. So now what we will do is, let us create a symbolic link. That means I don't want to call this jdk1.8.0_241, but instead I want to call this folder as JDK. So let's create a symbolic link. Okay, once this is done, say ls, you will see one folder called JDK. Say ls-ltr, you will see that JDK is a shortcut which is ultimately pointing to jdk1.8.0_241. Now onwards, you can call this folder as JDK only. Okay, and this will help us in many configuration files. All right, let's move on. Now we will edit our etc profile file. Okay, go down, absolutely down, press I, insert, enter. Okay, and then let's copy this piece of script. Now here we are basically setting our Java home to /user/local/java/jdk. Say escape colon wq, done. Now we have to inform our Ubuntu Linux system where is our Oracle Java JDK or JRE is located. So let's copy these two commands, what you see in green, and simply paste it. Done. Next, inform your Ubuntu Linux system that Oracle Java JDK or JRE must be the default Java. Done. Next. Now let's reload our etc profile file, whatever we have updated earlier. This is to refresh the file. Or if you really don't want to do this, that's okay. You can simply exit this terminal and launch the terminal again. Okay. Now let's try to say java-version. Okay. So it says 1.8.0_241, which means we have successfully installed Java in our Ubuntu system. Okay, now as our tutorial says, we will also install Eclipse as well as IntelliJ. So let's go back to our download folder where we have Eclipse and IntelliJ. Let's copy this. Let me paste it here in the Suraj folder. Let me paste it here directly. So we have copied these two files, Eclipse and IntelliJ. So what we will do is, let's extract this. You can say extract here. Similarly, let's do the same thing for this Eclipse as well. Say extract here. Okay, so once this is done, you can see they are extracted in two different folders. You can go inside this folder and you will see the directory structure like this, right? So let's rename it for our simplicity. So I'll just call it IntelliJ. And let me go back. This Eclipse, let me call it Eclipse itself. So what I'll do is, let me copy this into my main folder directly here as Eclipse. And let me go back to IntelliJ. Yeah, let me copy this IntelliJ here itself. Okay, so once this is done, you can remove other files and folders. So let's start with Eclipse first. Go to Eclipse and click on this Eclipse. Okay, so choose your working directory. I'll go with the default, say launch, and you get Eclipse like this. You can close this welcome screen. And now from here, you can say create a Java project, or you can also go to this file, new Java project. Let's create a default Java project. I'll say hello world Java. Okay, so we are going to use JDK 1.8 and just say finished. Now here you got a source file. Let's right click on it, say new, and say class. Let's create a package p1. Let's create a class called hello world class and say include public static void main, say finished. And now here let's just write SOP sysout control space, and here you write hello world, save. Okay, and let's run this program. All right, so if you see, we are able to run our simple hello world program in Eclipse. This is what we wanted to see after installing. Okay, so we are good with our Eclipse setup. Let's close it out. Now let's go to IntelliJ. Let's go to bin. So you have idea.sh. So we'll have to launch this. Okay, we'll have to launch this. So let's go to terminal, cd home, cd IntelliJ, cd bin, and here you see sh.idea.sh. Just say I accept, continue, don't send, and just say skip remaining and set the. So we have got IntelliJ. Now let's say create a new project. Java project. Say next. Give the some project name. Hello world. Say finished. Now you can close your tips. And just go to your project source, right click, new Java class, choose class and give some name, hello world demo. And let's write a main method here, main, enter, and you say south, enter, and say hello world. Save this. So please wait, it is indexing, so let's wait for some time. So once you have written this code, right click on it, say run hello world, and you got the output hello world. Okay, so this completes installation and setup of your IntelliJ as well as Eclipse. We will explore more on IntelliJ and Eclipse as part of the session later, but this is what we wanted to have, a minimum setup for a Hadoop developer. Okay, so in the next series, we will set up a Hadoop single node cluster on the same Ubuntu. Now you should shut down your Ubuntu first. So once this Ubuntu is shut down completely, let us go to the place where we have installed Ubuntu 19. It was on D drive virtual machine. So this is the image file. Okay, and it has occupied 13 GB of space. So the first thing what we should do is immediately compress it. Okay, so let's compress it and save it, so that in case tomorrow if something goes wrong, we can unzip this Ubuntu 19 and use it. You really don't have to again install Ubuntu, install Java, install Eclipse or install IntelliJ. Okay, so anytime anything goes wrong, you can just remove this Ubuntu 19 folder and unzip it and use it as fresh. So that's all on this video. In the next video, we will try to see how to install Hadoop 3 on the same Ubuntu machine.